I'm going to describe briefly an interactive simulation that models nine ideal vapor liquid equilibrium using the Margules equation. The simulation is located on the Wolfram site, and I've indicated here its location. And so you have two options. You can plot temperature versus mole fraction when this is selected, this button, and that's at just one pressure. Or you can plot look at the pressure versus mole fraction plot, and that again selecting this button, and that's then at one temperature. So in the simulation, you can move this black dot to go to different pressures, or in this case on the left to go to different temperatures. But keep in mind, these are not corresponding simulations. In other words, when I pick a point here, and this black dot can be moved to different conditions, I'm not looking at the same condition over on this plot. And when I show a plot of temperature versus mole fraction like so, the corresponding pressure mole fraction plot does not occur necessarily over here. Instead, there are other simulations for ideal cases that you can look at. So I've indicated location of simulation here for ideal solution where you can change the temperature in the PXY diagram to look at how the plot changes. You can change the pressure in the TXY diagram. So that's not also done here for these nine ideal solutions. So in these plots on the right side is a bar graph that shows the relative amounts of liquid and vapor, liquid in blue and the vapor in green. And then likewise, the green line corresponds to the dew point, and the blue line corresponds to the bubble point. When I pick the point here, there's two phases present. When I've moved the black dot here, it's all vapor, and that's reflected then in the bar graph. What this simulation allows you to do is change the two parameters in the Margules equation by moving these sliders. And as you change those parameters, the liquid mixture becomes more ideal for larger parameters. And these parameters can be either positive or negative. You can select here in case, this case we've selected positive. And then that causes positive or negative deviations from Raoult's law. So let's go to the simulation and look at this behavior. So here we're looking at the simulation, nine ideal liquid phase. Starting out condition where these parameters are zero, which is an ideal solution. So the bubble point line, the blue line, is a straight line. And then the corresponding TXY diagram when the parameters are zero, ideal solutions. These are not straight lines. So if I look at the PXY diagram and I increase the value of these parameters, I get positive deviations from Raoult's law when the parameters are positive. The activity coefficients are greater than one. And if I make this nine ideal enough, we start seeing that it's clear we have an azeotrope present. And I can move this black dot, and the bar graph then reflects the distribution between liquid and vapor. If I move the dot up to high pressure, we have all liquid present. You can correspondingly look at a TXY diagram. Positive deviations from Raoult's law in the pressure diagram are negative azeotrope temperature, right? We have a maximum pressure azeotrope, we have a minimum temperature azeotrope. I can also look at negative deviation from Raoult's law. So now we're back to ideal. Negative deviations, and again, if I make the deviations large enough, so now the activity coefficients are significantly less than one, but greater than zero, I get an azeotrope forming. And negative deviations refer to the pressure XY plot as negative deviation from Raoult's law. And again, I can move the dot around. in the two-phase region, see the distribution between liquid and vapor.